strange experience which Charlie had, and people say it is because he's very connected with the past and he wants to escape from his very busy, hectic life, right? And he does say that he has a very strange experience. He's not even talked to a psychiatrist about it. But once when he was coming out of the central station, he went to a corridor and he reached a level that does not exist there. He was very surprised to see. What all did he see on that third level? What all the things that he noticed? Yes? That how they were there, the locomotives were different, the people dresses were different. And he realized that, yes, he's gone to the past. And from the past, he was very much connected with one place. Which place was that? Galesburg. And he wanted to go to that place because he had a lot of pleasant childhood memories. And his grandfather always talked about that such a nice place it is and all the things about it. So he thought that was the perfect time to be born in and the perfect time to live, right? And yes, so that time, the First World War was away. The Second World War, so many years away, and everyone was living very peacefully. So he wanted to go to such a time when there were no problems, no worries, no tensions. And look at us here. Nowadays, in these times, there's a conflict and there's violence and everything. And you've been watching what is happening in, Afghanistan. And just imagine living in that kind of condition, isn't it? Right? So that is why, you know, we should be... Right, so let's come back to the chapter. And he did offer the clerk over there, the booking clerk, money. But when he saw the money, he said, this is not the right money. And he thinks that he's trying to cheat him or he's a fraud. And he says that he'll call the sheriff. And yes, so he gets very scared and he's saying that, okay, if I go to prison in this time, it's not a pleasant thing. Whether it is 1894. Or whichever year it is, going to prison is not a nice experience. Okay, so can we continue with the chapter? Yes, let's continue. And can you see the screen? Is it visible? Yes. Okay. So right. Now, then what did he do after that? After he came out of the third level, he immediately decided, you know, like whatever money he had in the bank, he changed it into the currency of that time, didn't he? Yes. And now he's got his wife also helping him to look for the third level. What's the name of his wife? Louisa. And both of them, what are they looking for? The third level. Why couldn't they leave the third level in the first place? Why couldn't he go to Galesburg there? Because he didn't have the right money. He had money, but it was not the right currency of that time. So he had to run away from there. And now he's looking for it. And do you think when you're looking for something consciously, you want to have that kind of experience again? It is generally not possible. So sometimes when you're not even aware and in your subconscious mind, so you have these kind of strange, unique experiences. So that is the only experience that we can have, okay? Now here, last lines we're doing, because one night, fussing with my stamp collection, I found, well, do you know what a first day cover is? When a new stamp is issued, stamp collectors buy some and use them to mail envelopes to themselves on the very first day of sale. And the postmark proves the date. The envelope is called a first day cover. They never opened. You just put blank paper in the envelope. So what do ticket stamp collectors do? So when a special stamp is released, they buy it and they self-addressed envelope. On that they paste it. And what would be there? The postmark would be there. That will prove the date, the release of the date, and it will add to its value also, right? And yes, so here in that envelope, generally it is left blank or just a blank paper is put. Nobody sends a letter in that. So here that night, he was going through his stamp collection. Whose stamp collection did he inherit? He's inherited his grandfather's stamp collection. So that night, among my oldest first day covers, I found one that shouldn't have been there. So he's been going through his stamp collection. It's been with him for so many years. he found one which should not have been there. There was a stamp which should not have been there, but there it was. Or a first aid cover was there. It was there because someone had mailed it to my grandfather at his home in Galesburg. That's what the address on the envelope said. So he found a first aid cover, or he found a letter which should not have been there, and it had been addressed to his grandfather's address in Galesburg. Why did he want to go to Galesburg? Yes, Abhishek. Who lived in Galesburg? Yes? His grandfather lived over there, and he wants to go there because it's a nice, peaceful place. Right, Pratham, where is your book? Where's your book? So when are you going to buy it? So that night, among my, okay, I read this. That's what the address on envelope said, and it had been there since July 18, 1894. The postmark showed that. July 18, 1894, and he wanted to go back to 1894. Yet I didn't remember it at all, and he does not remember seeing this envelope there because he is very fond of his collection and he goes through it frequently. The stamp was a 6 cent dull brown with a picture of President Garfield. Naturally, when the envelope came to Granddad in the mail, it went right into his collection and stayed there till I took it out and opened it. So yeah, so like how his letter reached there in the present time, and it must have, because he's talking about 1894, and that time when his grandfather was collecting stamps, the letter would have gone to him, right? The paper inside wasn't blank because he has never seen it before. What did he do? He took it out and he's just looking at it and wondering what is there inside because he has never seen this letter before. What was there inside? There was a paper, but it was not blank. Jenny, what is there in the first day cover? What is the first day cover? Come on, quickly tell me. And class 12, tomorrow onwards, you will join my class with your videos on. Upon entry, your videos should be on. Let me see your faces. After that, you can turn off your video. But let me see you all. And who's attending the class and who isn't. Right? And yes, here. Yeah, Mr. Shashank, can you tell me what is the first day cover? You can raise your hand. I can unmute you. Vidisha? What's the first day cover? Yes, and why is it very important for stamp collectors? What is the sequence of receiving a first day cover? What happens first? What are the steps here of receiving a first day cover? Can anybody tell me? What would the person do who's sending a first day cover? You'll buy a stamp of a particular date or occasion, right? So when it is released, then what do you do? Where will he paste the stamp? On an envelope? What would he written on the envelope? His own address? It would be self-addressed. Then what would he do? He'll post it. And what will happen to the letter? The post office. There would be a stamp, the postmark. And what would the postmark prove? The date of release of the stamp. Clear? I can ask you such kind of question. What are the steps of the first day cover, right? This is one kind of question that you're going to get. So you should be able to identify the sequence in which things are done, okay? Right, so when you open the letter, what was there? I got to wishing, Charlie, that you were right. Then I got to believing you were right. And Charlie, it's true, I found the third level. I've been here 2 weeks, and right now down the street at the Dailies, someone is playing a piano and they're all out in the front porch singing, seeing Nelly home, and I'm invited over for lemonade. Come on back, Charlie and Louisa, keep looking till you find the third level. It's worth it, believe me. So he's got a letter. The letter is not addressed to his grandfather. The letter is addressed to Charlie. Who has written the letter? Sam. Who is Sam? Who's Sam? Anybody? Who's Sam? Very good. Sam is his psychiatrist. Yes. The note is signed Sam, and Sam has found the third level. Whom did he hear about the third level from? Charlie. And when Charlie told him, I found the third level, what did Charlie start doing? He started looking for it again because he had the money. He wanted to buy a ticket to Galesburg, right? And he was there in the year 1894 and he wanted to go back in time. But who has gone there? His psychiatrist has gone there, which is the biggest irony. At the stamp and coin store I go to, I found that Sam bought $800 worth of old style currency. That ought to set him up in a nice little hay, feed and grain business because there were no psychiatrists at that time. He always said that's what he really wished he could do, and he certainly can't back to his old business, not in Galesburg, Illinois in 1894. His old business, where Sam was my psychiatrist. Now, if a psychiatrist has some kind of health issues, mental health issues, who will he go to? Another psychiatrist? But see, all the while, he's been treating Charlie, he's been talking to him, he's been trying to convince him that all these problems that you're having, it is because of your sense of insecurity, it is because you're having a lot of issues nowadays. But what about his psychiatrist? Is his psychiatrist mentally sound himself? Or his psychiatrist also wants to escape? His psychiatrist has also escaped to the third level before Charlie and Louisa. So what is the irony in this whole situation? And why can't Sam go back to his old business? Did we have psychiatrists in 1894? No, even now people are not even aware. What about in 1894? Do you think people would be going to psychiatrist? So what business do you think he set up? He said, look, I have, he's thinking that he could have started his hay, feed and grain business to feed the cattle. Fodder for the cattle, so he could have started that. Could have done farming and lived a nice, peaceful, comfortable life. Okay? Do you think Sam would be happy there? Sam is happy there? Yes. And he wants Charlie and Louisa also to join him. He say, keep on looking. Don't give up. Keep on looking for the third level. You'll find it. And then come here. Life is very peaceful. Life is very good. Okay? Why do we want to escape from the present? Once again, the big question, why do we want to escape? Curiosity to see the future, curiosity to experience the past also, is it? Right? And of course, here, once again, when you talk about peace of mind, if we remember the poem, Keeping Quiet, there the poet says that this unhappiness we have made for ourselves. We have only made ourselves unhappy. How can we stop that? By living in the present, how can we find peace for ourselves? Yes? How can we find peace for ourselves? Anyone? By taking a break, by stopping what we're doing, by thinking, reflecting over things that we are doing. Okay? Right? So, yes, so we can overcome this. We can be at peace with ourselves if we take our time to think and reflect. And if you remember the word, introspect. So Charlie, yes, maybe he did need a little bit of break, and because of all the problems and the pressures and the insecurities that he had, and then things would have come back to normal. Okay, right. Yes, so here, let us just go through the questions here. Do you think that the third level was a medium of escape for Charlie? Why? Was it a medium of escape? Yes. He wanted to escape the modern life. He wanted to escape all the problems that he was experiencing. Now, what do you infer from Sam's letter to Charlie? What do you understand from that letter? Sam has gone to the third level. Sam is happy there. And Sam is inviting Charlie also, that don't give up, keep on looking for the third level, you'll find it eventually, right? The modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and stress. What are the ways in which we attempt to overcome them? So just like now I've asked you, what do you do when you are stressed out? What are the things that you do? Meditation. Okay, what do you people do? Yes? What do you do? Listening to song. Music is a big stress buster. Sleep. Yes, some people think the best thing is let's sleep over our problems. Tomorrow is another day. We'll think about it tomorrow. What is going to happen? So let's drinking tea. Okay, that's nice. Someone people, right? Yeah, so your tea and coffee. Some people eat a lot when they're stressed. Yes. Sometimes. What do you do, Ankit? Nothing. What does he have? You eat a lot. Okay. Yes, so there are various ways that we have. Some people, they go for a walk or they're running and exercising, you know, so they just want to release, you know, all that negativity that they have or maybe all the tension that they have, right? So we all have our ways in which to deal with them. How we overcome here? Our fears. You have a fear. Like we remember we discussed deep water, that fear of water. So we have that fear. Some people have a fear of failure. They're so afraid of that. So that is why before the exams, so much of panic and so much of stress, right? So that fear is there among our minds. So we have that fear, yes, that something bad might happen and one day I might lose everything that I have. So that is maybe a fear that everybody has. No? So, because you're quite younger right now, that is why. So, yeah, so go for a walk, listen to music, read a book. Nobody said reading. Watch television. Yeah, we do that. Binge watching, isn't it? Right? So, whatever is there, anything that makes you forget your problems and your worries. Do you see an intersection of time and space in the story? When did this intersection take place of time and space? When does this happen? Of the past time in the present scenario or vice versa? When was there an intersection? What is intersection? A crossing, right? So where was that moment when both the times were there present? Charlie was in the modern world, but the setting was of the past. When did that happen? When did that happen? When he found the third level, right? And when he went to the railway platform, when he took out money to buy a ticket to verify himself, where am I? He looked at the newspaper. So that was intersection of time and space. Okay? Clear? Please note it down. Apparent illogicality sometimes turns out to be a futuristic projection. Discuss. What does this line mean? Somebody please explain this line to me. Apparent illogicality sometimes turns out to be a futuristic projection. Things which might appear illogical right now. These ideas, yes, might be, you can say, possible in the future, right? So we are there living at a time where so many changes have happened. You can say that in the past two decades, right, there's been a lump, you know, what jumps and leaps when it comes to technology, right? So look at the moment that we are in now. If someone told you, and if like when we read that story, also the fun they had, if you remember in class 9th, that was about the future schools, how everybody had their personal robot and they were taught, yes. So could you think of it that something is similar is going to happen to you? That maybe in another year, you are also going to have a similar experience. So this is there, you know, like what appears to be something very illogical. It is now, yes, it is happening, right? So many things. Which inventions and, you know, like discoveries do you think here, right? You thought that, okay, it's not going to last long. It's just a craze. It's a passing time. What the things you think were there being discussed there? And like when these things came here, like you know, when you think about touch screen and all, now we it is such a part of our life. We never thought that okay, things could be without that, right? And we have become so lazy. We had never thought that you just have to speak in your phone and yeah, your message would be typed, isn't it? Right? So we are there. We never thought that technology would become an extension of our lives. Talk about artificial intelligence. We have Alexa answering for you and right, finding out the answers there. So this is something which has happened, things which were unbelievable in the past, right? So yes, yeah, so it is there, you know, where because you have a vision, you have an idea, then these things are implemented. And see, look at you, you're safe at home and you are attending your classes. What more do you want? Right? So this is there. So yeah, people are made fun of, people laugh at them, like, see, what are the things that they have discussed? And of course, so when you look at your gaming arena, also the games which you have there, right? So we never thought that virtual reality would be something, a reality, you know, right? So these are the things that have happened. So all these changes have happened and they have become a part of our life. Okay, yes, so philately helps keep the past alive. Discuss other ways in which this is done. What do you think of the human tendency to constantly move between the past, the present, and the future? It seems we are so insecure. We want to know about the past also, right? We want to enjoy a life in the present, but we also want to see what is going to happen in the future. Like nowadays, we're talking about, you know, like what even cars are going to be, what, self-driven and maybe giving a command only and they'll be moving and things like that, isn't it? So maybe such kind of a thing would be there. Yes. So like you have trains which are moving at such a fast speed and distance has been reduced. Right. So, yes. What are the other ways in which we are connected to the past? Mohit, tell me. What other ways can we remain connected with the past? One is stamp collecting. What other things can you do to remain connected? Old coins, yes, the coin collection, very nice. What else? So people are there, you know, like some people, they have, you know, like vintage things, old things, right? So, things that belong to the past, right? We have very expensive hobbies also. People are there, you know, like they have their vintage cars also, right? From that, yeah. So we have museums also, which show about the, yes, the locomotives there, the trains, how they were in the past and how they are there. So we have train museums also. We have people there. You know? And of course, if we are so concerned about, our, you know, like, a good future. We're worried about that also. We're thinking what is going to happen in the future. Do you think our constant juggling between the past and the future does not let us enjoy the present moment? So isn't it right? We do talk about that. Yes, live the moment. But we are there, you know. Yeah, we want to know about the past also. We're curious about the future. And maybe in all that, we are unable to enjoy the present. So this is human tendency. We want to know about the past. We've read about the chapter also discovering church, right? How he was there so many years old and he was taken out. So we want to connect with that. We want to find out what happened there, right? Okay. Now you have read Adventure by Jayant Narlikar in Hornbill, class 11th. Compare the intervening of fantasy and reality in those two stories. So if you remember, well, you did not do adventure because it was not in your syllabus, it was deleted. So that is also something like this, you know, in that chapter, there is a belief that there is an alternate universe. And sometimes you think of it like that, you know, maybe are we the only, you know, is this the only world here? Are events happening at some other time, some other place? Right? So we have that here. So in that chapter also, just like here, the third level he looks for, he goes to that platform, right? Reaches the past. So even there also in the same chapter, he was talking about reading about history and he keeps on thinking about that. What if the Marathas had not lost the Battle of Panipat? What would have history been like? We also think about, What if partition had not happened? What if the First World War had not happened? What if the Second World did not took place? Right? What if Kargil had not happened? Right? If Corona had not happened, maybe this is something that we'll all want to change when you think about that, isn't it? Right? Then what would have life been like? Right? So yes, it is the curiosity of the mind. But why was it surprising to find that Sam was there reaching the third level before Charlie? That is the strangest part. Who's going to take care of Charlie now? Who's going to listen to him? And he's saying, you come here, you come to Galesburg, you won't have any problems only. And we won't have anything to talk about or worry about or discuss. So happiness is that what we keep on seeking throughout our life, a peace of mind. So with this, we come to an end of this chapter. Yes? Rest, or rather we'll start a new chapter tomorrow, okay? Right.